Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Potter's Resort here in Norfolk for the Just 2021 World Indoor Bowls Championships. Coming up very shortly, well, we have another fantastic game for you, so let's have a quick look. And now let's have a look at the order of play for the rest of today. And back to the next game, our match officials are as follows. And now, ladies and gentlemen, very shortly we'll be handing you over to the commentary team of the BBC.
Yes, first out onto the portable rink this afternoon. From Wales, we have a WIBC champion with national singles and triple titles to her name. She's a Commonwealth silver medalist and 2 times mixed pairs world champion and former winner of this event. Looking to regain that title, please give a warm welcome to Laura Daniels. Her opponent in this final has 12 national and British Isles titles. She is a world mixed pairs champion and 3 times ladies match play champion. Looking to bring that total up to 4 today. Give it up for England's Katherine Rednall.
Thank you, Rishi. Different type of game this, of course. Not only is it a final, but over the 11 ends in each set. And the opponent's different for Katherine Rednall. Alex Marshall, very attacking player, big heavy drives, and on occasions just very subtle conversion shots. Laura Daniels, very much a draw shot player, but she's been very accurate with her running balls in this event. It's split opinion, isn't it, Sian, about whether it's good to go back-to-back matches and whether it puts a player off or whether a player quite likes it. Nobody really knows.
I think there's advantages and disadvantages. I think it obviously depends a lot on how the first game has gone. Katherine coming off the back of a big win, she'll have a lot of confidence, and it's a nice position to be in going into a game so soon.
One green.
How far short of Jack High is Katherine's ball?
3 inches short of Jack High.
Good start to the first end. It's very important to get settled in the game. Katherine Rednall changing from the green balls to the red. Should make any difference. Some play people think it does, but I don't think Katherine will be too concerned.
Very good here, sitting off the green. Just squeeze the jack.
One red.
I'm just getting the front edge of the green by sitting down. That was such a good game this afternoon though, David, wasn't it? Oh. Like, played at the highest standard, and the way they played it, the way they were interacting with one another as well, I think it was such a good advert for bowls in general.
Super game, no doubt. Alex was exceptional in it as well.
Yeah, they both played brilliantly.
Well, that's just dropping a little bit short, just trying to get to the jack to turn it for two. Not an easy add, this one. Gap only about 5 or 6 inches.
One shot, Katherine Rednall.
1-0, first out.
I think we have to remember that both these players have played at the very highest level outdoors as well. And, you know, you can play 4-hour matches there, sometimes back-to-back at major championships. So a back-to-back match here isn't a big issue. That's not the point, though. When this draw was made, obviously there were two players included. Darren Burnett and Nikki Brett, and when they withdrew due to injury, we had Julie Forrest come in and Katherine Rednall. But a long discussion with Katherine about, was she happy enough to play back-to-back matches,
and
made it very clear
minutes.
She was, and it was very much down to the player.
And in the national finals, you play 2, sometimes 3 games in a day. It's they're used to it.
Absolutely. The only factor is, obviously, she's awaiting a little one in a couple of months' time. but she feels very healthy and is happy enough to go along with it, and it's up to the player in many ways, and that was good. So Laura off on the forehand, very few players leading on the forehand coming this direction.
That's a good start here.
One green.
What's the gap on Laura?
5 inches. Your last bowl, 4 feet past Jack High.
Yes, it's a deep red ball she's looking for, the one that's just about half a yard behind the jack. Trying to stop on that if she can. Gets to the jack, it's a bonus.
Yeah, very good. Does two jobs, covers and counts.
Two green.
Bow here, Corky.
Oh, yep. Got this
great
one.
Great bow here.
No, played that well. Played it very well.
Yeah, she played it perfectly.
Very little to play at here. Front ball red on the jack's not good. We'll go to the deep red one. So a little turn of the jack is the only way to get the shot.
I'm out cool.
Just needed a little bit more.
One shot, Katherine Rednall.
Picked out the line.
Set score 2-0 after two ends.
Laura has 5 timeouts remaining.
An extra timeout is added when it comes to the 11 ends. 6 given, that's an extra minute to play your ball. So what they do is it goes back, and if you're running down the 30 seconds after the first delivery, you get down to low figures, you're not ready, you can ask for it to be reset.
26 and
a half
minutes.
It resets itself effectively in the computer to 30 seconds and adds another 30 onto it. First one, excellent. And you repeat it again, Lord, by getting onto the red ball. It's just hanging off. There's a slightly inside line in the backhand. Trouble is, if you go fishing for it, you might just miss it on the inside and then it dives away quickly.
She's not as far away as she thinks.
Nope, she could roll off this.
She's got the shot.
Yep. Well, sometimes when you hit a ball, you're shaking her head. I think she reckons she was a lot heavier with that one.
Yeah, I think she thought she was flying.
Shot ball past Jack High.
Shot ball is 6 inches past Jack High, gap of 4 inches.
When you hit a ball sometimes with a foot or two, you can actually roll off it and end up closer than just hitting the ball and staying on it. It doesn't fall.
On the tight line this time, played it well.
Narrowed it down. Looking for that inside line. Got it. Didn't get the flop onto the jack to make a double, but it's still a very good ball. Doesn't want to touch the green one. Oh, I thought that was going to drop. If it drops, it'll hit the green one. It'll hit the jack, it'll be two.
Just struggled a bit to get back with that extra pace.
It's a sport of small margins. Again, there's a chance of getting onto her own ball with this one. Drop
it
down. Onto the jack. Could make a double. It's all it needed.
Two shots, Laura Daniels.
Good end. Good end of bows.
Yep. It just needed to be touched. That was all.
Set score 2-2.
There we go. Drop it down. Move the jack an inch or so. Two shots.
Played it perfectly.
Laura Daniels, such a good player. Wins a lot of things outdoors. Watched her win the British Isles gold medal as well in the World Championships. She's very talented. Sometimes gets a bit overlooked, I think, but when you look at her CV, it's impressive.
Track length, 24 and a half metres.
So good, first ball.
I think that's Katherine Rednall's true strength, first two bowls. I mean, she's dangerous because she's got the whole range of shots, but I think that is what sets her apart. And probably because she spent so many years leading, it's just bang, bang, bang. She's like a machine.
Well, that's the same in many ways for Laura. She's very much a front-end player, but has the weight shots, which we may see in this match, more than likely will. Katherine has the full range, there's no doubt about that. But ultimately, it's the draw shots that really count.
Two red.
David Brand once said to me that you will win matches occasionally with the dry shot, but you win titles with the draw.
And in team games, you win from the front, don't you? If your front end is setting up the heads for you, it's easy.
I told you that when you won your gold medal in Glasgow.
Yeah, I just made up the numbers, didn't I? Makes such a difference, though. You stand up the other end watching them shell peas, it's happy days.
Absolutely. I'm thinking balls, we call it an armchair ride. You know, just let them get on with it. Anyway, chance for this one.
Yeah, good again, come just out. Drifting past their front well.
That's ideal.
Very good.
Excellent stuff.
Three red.
Needs to come back very quickly. Struggling. Yep, over the weight. Anything over that weight and it's going to be a battle if you're out on the draw line. There is a narrow line again on this backhand. Both backhands have got narrow lines available to them, but the margins are very small. You miss it by half a ball, it dives away very quick. A lot of players aren't prepared to go for that. This is going to be very costly.
Yeah, it's a nice pickup for Katherine Rednall. Stamping her foot.
Well, she knows she's slightly over the weight, but I think it's good enough.
She's good enough.
Well, not sure, because the front green one has to come into play. Might be a measure on that. But the experts will let us know.
Umpire, please. You can.
Francis Fletcher calling for the umpire. Dan Blewett on umpire duty. In. It's always good to know the experts are right.
Four shots, Katherine Rednall. Set score 6-2 after four ends. Length 27
metres. Those loose ends are very, very dangerous, and really Katherine didn't have to do much to get that full house. It was just very straightforward, normal draws, weren't even that close.
And that was an easy pickup for her. Laura was just that bit looser than she had been the previous three ends and cost her dearly, unfortunately. And now the pressure's really on. Katherine's just got that bit of momentum behind her. Very good again.
Laura Daniels beat Rebecca Wilgris 2-0 in a tie break. Very good game, good quality. Before that was Carla Banks, young player from Scotland, again on a tie break, 2-1 this time, rather than 2-0.
Two red.
Katherine Rednall beat Devon Cooper 9-2, 8-4 in her semi-final. Previous game, because it's a limited field, only 8 players, who was due to play Ellen Faulkner, but she withdrew due to injury. Consistencies there, putting balls in the head. It wears you down because you're always looking for the big ball to get you out of trouble. And short balls don't help. It's a useful one, but still 3 down.
3 red.
There's no hit shot, really. Laura's good at the driving.
Yeah, but you need to have the position, don't you, in order to do it? Catherine's just building off her head here.
And the short balls are wrecking her, really.
I think we found that the set that Laura lost against Rebecca Wilgris, it was short balls that cost her as well.
Yes, it was.
Just makes life so much harder for yourself.
Interesting change, wonder why. Door still open for a good draw, but it's dangerous because of the simple reason that if you're just slightly over the weight, even a foot or so, it'll just hold off like her previous one.
Yeah, she's gone more aggressive because she's got a back bowl now. It looks nice. Needs to hold. One gone.
Could have been better. She was bang on target.
Two
could
shots,
have taken
Catherine
two out.
Yeah, I think it was just a case of trying to clear something, reduce the count.
Set score 8-2 off the 5 ends.
A slight element of frustration as well, Sam.
She comes, yeah. Catherine's back bowl gone, still 2. Yeah, of course it's frustrating. She struggled with her first bowls to find the pace, and she knows that she needs to get on the scoreboard and, you know, add to the 2 that she's got.
Let one run down on a running ball, try and get her arm loosened.
Track length 23.5 metres.
Correction, very good correction.
Right in front. Not a toucher, but a very good ball. And that means now that Laura has to be, if anything, just behind the jack. Anything from a foot, 2 or 3 feet would be good.
She's got to give herself an option for the third and fourth ball. Good, finish well.
Yep,
good ball there. Will at some stage have to change onto the backhand. Don't think she'll get the shot in the forehand. There's still 6 ends to play in this set. Yeah, it's an even better one.
She's really playing well.
Got a chance with this. Needs to hold.
She's got Catherine's front bow.
Not the gap.
No.
Oh dear, oh dear. Well. Sometimes you're better being off target by a distance to get a result. That was just so close.
It was close.
And Catherine's having a look at this, but surely she'll go deep. When she's line two, she's sitting well.
I don't think she needs to be adding. Much better off.
Catherine has five
protecting the back position.
Well, just the way it's sitting, there is a. It's worthwhile playing down into this sort of area if she can. If she pops a ball in there, it's going to look absolutely brilliant from a point of view of position.
Yep. That's what she'll be looking to cover.
Here the ball comes. Deep in position now. If Laura hits the ball onto the jack, at least she's got a chance. Now there is a deeper green ball. And Laura will be thinking that will come to the rescue. Oh my. She's gone back to the in-between weight, and that's just after missing really so close. Why did she go back to the hard shot?
I think possibly a little bit of indecision of how much weight to play.
Two
and ended up
Catherine
something in the middle that achieved nothing.
Yeah, that's such a low percentage shot. That sort of weight.
She had the best back. Catherine obviously took away the chance for her getting a two, but she could have smacked it.
Technical term, of course.
Yeah.
Just hit it and hope for a good result.
Sometimes you just need to give it a smack.
You do.
For 26 metres.
Laura's going to have to get this first ball going to put pressure on the Catherine Rednall, because at the moment she's getting a pretty free run. Hasn't been asked too many questions so far, Shan.
No, she's had the space to get in, and you know she's settled into her pace really nicely because she's just been drawing away.
That's what's happening. If she misses with the first, she's getting him in the second.
There's not been many firsts that she's missed with either.
Exactly. Or just means to move up the game a bit. Of course, it is sets play. That changes things. Got a chance with this one.
Yeah, good ball here. Pace was enough, I think.
Gap on yours, 4 inches.
Doesn't show too much emotion. Laura, a cool, calm player.
One red.
Mm-hmm. Oh, a little touch of the jack round the corner would be good here, Laura.
This was not easy. You almost feel like you're going to have to steer the ball into the right line, and it's easy to miss it. She's looking at what would happen if she plays the front plant onto the green ball, onto the jack. A chance in the backhand of doing that as well.
Timeout called. Laura has four timeouts remaining.
It's not easy, though.
That's not an easy shot at all.
No, I can see what, you know, the ideal shot is to draw it there and then extend the jack. But there is a hit shot into here on the backhand. Now, that other one just above that, Mark, is the plant. So there's a percentage shot in the backhand, hoping for a little bit of luck.
Yeah, there's a lot to be wrecked on. Catherine's got three short bowls.
Yeah.
It doesn't look great from the mat.
No, problem with the forehand is with the draw shot, it's very exact. Going for the runner.
On the forehand.
I think she was looking for that plant. Oh, another gap. Ooh.
One shot, Catherine Rednall.
On another day, she comes off something and wings into the head.
Set score 11-2 after 7
You can see
minutes.
She just pulled it off the mat, found the gap.
Two good drives, Laura Daniels, but through the gap both times.
Track length 25.5 metres.
First ball service resumed. Getting close. Well done, Laura. Good ball in there. Oh, this is good again.
I think when Katherine Rednall was playing like she is, like, Laura needs to be looking to match her bowl by bowl, and she hasn't been doing that in this set so far, and that makes the difference.
It's either that or be extremely aggressive and bunch her balls around the place with weight shots, and that's not Laura's game.
No, it's not, and she hasn't had the position from where her other bowls have been to be able to do that either. So she's made life difficult for herself.
Two red.
Maybe a change onto the forehand here, because you're bringing the jack towards the green ball on the backhand.
Yeah, she can sit inside the Laura Daniels bowl. No. She's not.
This is brave. This is very clearly an inside line, Laura, so you have to have the weight to hold it.
She's got the weight, all right.
My goodness me, how on earth did that not get back? That was 2 feet inside her previous bowl. There's different lines in that hand, there's no doubt about it.
Sensible by from Katherine to cover, just in case. She'd be silly to lose a three out there if the jack was to squeeze.
Having another go at it. Another double against her.
coming back from there.
It's fighting it all the way. Yeah. No. Too many multiples, that's the problem.
Two shots, Katherine Rednall.
Set score 13-2 after 8 ends.
That's the 4, David, on the fourth end.
It was a loose end, but 11 shots. That's the problem in 5 ends with no reply and 3 doubles, a 4 and a single.
Track length 25 metres.
Should be over this end, this set, but Laura Daniels will be thinking about the next set. So just concentrate and try and get a drawing weight off the rink.
That's right, and that is the beauty of set play, as we've said before.
Too
chance
many,
to regroup.
Two mini games, isn't it? Two small mini games into the match.
Yeah, and you have to look at it like that, regardless of what the scores were on the first set, you've got another opportunity.
No let up with Katherine. If she misses with the first, she's right in there with the second. This is better.
Yeah, she's better here.
She wants to bounce the jack.
One red.
It's not going well. It really isn't going well. Just bounce the jack. It was as soon as she hit it middle ball, it was going to go. The one to red. She needs 3 this end. Laura Daniels. So it's just a matter of trying to get into these 2 red balls if possible. Probably worth playing a little bit of weight.
Yep, nothing to lose by adding a bit. She's on a decent line, not quite got the pace.
One red.
Has to go for the 2 balls. Possible to get the both of them the way they're sitting. Very controlled weight. So would have been a little bit heavier than this.
Just needs to hold. Just.
Well, at the moment she can't buy a shot.
One shot and the first set. Katherine Rednall.
Well, that was a very comfortable first set. For Katherine Rednall, 14-2. Played well, played consistent, played good, steady balls. Particularly the lead balls. Laura Daniels hasn't settled at all.
No, I don't think we've seen the Laura Daniels that, you know, we could be seeing. So hopefully this set...
25 metres.
Will be better. Nice position for Katherine not to have to play the last 2 ends of a set.
Yes.
Very in control right from the start, really. And like I say, picking up that four just seemed to give her the momentum, and she didn't drop an end after that.
Katherine Rednall doing what she's been doing quite a lot this week. First ball on the jack, won the first set 14 shots to 2 against a rather out of form Laura Daniels, and she'll be hoping that in this 11 end set she can bounce back, put a bit of pressure on, force a tie break. Nice little rest on the ball, and then fell against the bias to go right in front of the jack. Everything's going right at the moment.
That's how it is when you've got a big lead, isn't it? If things are going well, if everything feels comfortable, it's a good place to be.
One red.
And taking her time, this will be a timeout. Plenty of them to play with. Carrying her ball up.
Timeout call. Katherine has 4 timeouts remaining.
Changing the laws quite a few years ago, and it'll enable you to do that. At one point, you weren't allowed to. I don't think she can make this an awful lot better. Only just a ball behind the jack would be useful.
Yeah, it's just coming down to look at the angle, see what Laura might be playing. Certainly a bolt. A couple of yards through wouldn't hurt.
Yes, it's always anticipation. That's all. Trying to work out one ball, two balls ahead. Like a chess game. Not so much in singles because there's restricted balls, but certainly in fours. Well, that's going to come in front.
Second prize there.
Yep. Yeah, it's a poor ball, but a good result. Laura just trying to edge into her own. Clear road around it, drop back. Very subtle shot.
Yeah, she's tried to play that very hard, neat shot there.
Two green balls in there, I think. Really, that's a hit shot to open something up.
Yeah, she can play weight at that.
I think do it with the third ball because she has the last ball, Laura Daniels, and just try and shake the game up a little bit.
Yeah, and even the split on her front bow and Catherine's would be good. Get the run on. Katherine Rednall making sure this time.
Ideal result would be to get into this ball if she possibly can. Bring the jack out into this position. There's a chance of scoring with the other balls then.
She's going for the backhand.
Oh, she's playing the backhand. It'll hang off all day.
That was not the right shot.
No, that was the. No, it's not like her,
one
shot, it's a hard shot. And
1-0, first end.
It's all personal choice, of course, but you have to look at the percentages and things aren't going well. May not go for the exact shot, go for something that might give you something out of it. Daniels, when she had the chance to get the jack, when she scored a double in the third end,
25 and a half metres,
came down quite short. All the rest of the time was more towards the middle to late. And Katherine Rednall sticking to that sort of mid-length. Nobody's going particularly long at the moment. That's the best first bowl.
Yeah, very good start. Great opening bowl from Laura Daniels.
Good effort, but not counting. Half decent protector, though. So she has to start. Laura has to force Katherine into these difficult shots. Anything just behind the jack would be good. Trying hard with this.
Very good bow here. Very good bow.
Yep. Well done. Good position.
Yep.
One green.
It's not a counter, but it's it'll put a thought into Catherine's mind about how much weight she can use to come into this. That last ball changed her in terms of what she could do.
Like you say, it made her think about it. She couldn't fly at it.
Catherine's bowl 7 inches short of jack high.
How fast did I go with my last?
Yours 20 inches.
Here, Laura's Welsh accent coming through there, lovely and clear. Yep.
Well played.
Little touch. I wonder. Might have been unlucky. A little bit further. Definitely guaranteed a double.
One shot, Laura Daniels.
Very unlucky there.
It's unlucky. It's a good ball.
Yep. Another inch or so. She guaranteed the two. No movement on the jack. She guaranteed the two. But on the card, needs to play more ends like that. Players, of course, are using different mats, yellow for the green player and a red for the red player. Jacks are sanitized every end.
Sentence you ever thought you'd hear yourself say, is it?
No, it's not. It's not.
Jack length 28 and a half metres.
Unusual times.
Really good. This is what she needs to do. She needs to put Katherine Rednall under some pressure. Last end was the first time Katherine's had to play any other shot than a draw.
It all came from the first delivery, being close to the jack. And because it's a closed arena, the difficulty here is that obviously there's no support either way for the players, but a lot of people will be watching at home, and I'm sure that'll be the case for Laura as well, wanting Laura to up her game to try and get back into this match.
You're great bowling.
Well, that's very much more like the Lord Daniels we're used to.
Yeah, we want to see them slog it out, don't we?
Yeah, we do. Yes, we want a great game. This is close.
Very close. Great bowl here from Katherine Rednall.
Two green.
Just dropping up, pulling up there. It's not a bad finish, though.
Gives her an option.
It does.
Anything behind the jack doesn't matter really how far, but just make sure you're behind the jack.
Yeah, Katherine's got her own ball to play up now. It's finished well for her to do that.
Oh, Laura.
This is not here either.
What are you doing down there? Yeah, she's sort of smacking her hands on the way up there. Should still be two, but
two green.
She'll have to go deep this time, and if she'd have been there with her third bowl, she could have been looking at drawing for a third shot instead. Now she has to waste one and put it around the back. Good.
Yeah, she had to be there. There's no doubt that Katherine Rednall's not going to play weight with this ball.
Well, she might change her mind now because there's really no position. I think to herself, I can draw a second. I'm not going to get the shot this end. It's a 11 end set. Long way to go.
I'd expect to see her arriving into it. Just over. Nothing silly.
Down on a draw line, hasn't pushed through it though.
Two shots, Laura Daniels.
She was trying to draw it. I can understand why. Could have cost her another one if it had gone wrong.
Set score 1-3 after 3 ends.
So Katherine Rednall. 3-1 down in this, but won the first set comfortably, 14-2. The set looks to be a totally different thing altogether at the moment because Laura Daniels is getting in with that first ball and putting pressure on.
Track length 28.5 metres.
Short, the first time in 3 ends that's happened. As I say in the bowls, good weight wasted. That was Katherine Rednall's bowl. Perfect weight, missed the line. This is one of these dangerous loose ends building up.
Katherine Rednall won't miss the line twice.
There's the correction to come in for shot. Still plenty of room. This end's turned out to be a bit of a struggle.
That's a hit.
Yeah, well, not only that, but it's closing the head down as well.
Yeah, little touch of the jack. Here she comes, little touch, taking
quarter
it closer to her
short
own
of
bolt.
Draw shot, second shot is the target. You get the shot, it's a real bonus. Needs to be reaching though.
It's lacking pace.
Yeah. Well, this is going to be a very cheap three by the looks of it. Well, that's struggling. Goodness me, what a chance. Real loose end.
Every end, Katherine bowled a different line, that end. So the last one being the widest.
Set score 3-3 after 4 end.
Well, the two girls will be chatting away about that end because it was a very strange one, as it turned out. Katherine Rednall scored a double, but probably should have been three shots.
Yeah, Laura was let off the hook a little bit there.
Track length 23.5 metres.
That's good stuff. Two good balls. Sets up the head. This is good.
Very good here.
Well played, Laura.
One green.
We're just getting flashes of Laura in this set, in particular, of a really tidy bowling.
Yeah, I think aside from the last end, this set's been a lot better from Laura. A lot better grouping.
Yeah, this is narrow. You get caught in that inside line and it will just dive away. You've probably only missed the line by a bowl. Time the ball gets up to the jack, it's 5-6 feet away.
Yeah, it's very unforgiving there.
Center rink, but anything behind the jack would have been useful. Might have a certain amount of value if Katherine decides to have a running ball at this. Nothing really good about it. It's not sitting well. There's only one shot in it.
Katherine has 3 timeouts remaining.
The inside line again, this time with more weight.
Yeah, she's gone quicker. It's still going to go on her.
Don't think there'll be any damage done though. Now, Laura, you're going to score in a double here. If you can, a little touch on the ball under the jack would be a real bonus. Might make 3.
It'd be lovely for her.
That's not easy.
No, just trying to draw the shot first and foremost. Draw second. She make it back?
Don't think so. Well, if you're not sure, measure it. Nope, sure not.
One shot, Laura Daniels.
Set score 3-4 after 5 ends.
That card looks an awful lot better for the Laura Daniels fans.
I think the only thing I'd say is Laura hasn't been adding. She's had a couple of opportunities to add another shot and she hasn't done it in the same way that Katherine did in the first set she had the same opportunities.
Haven't been maybe just as easy, to be fair. Hasn't had a lot of room for the spare shot, but they do add up.
Jack length, 28 and a half metres.
Again, getting in, forcing Katherine to play a good ball.
It's closer this time.
It's running a little bit, so we could bounce the jack. Good ball, but again, that's the advantage of getting one those green balls in. You know, in the first set, Katherine was picking up the jack.
And the jack is Katherine's ball.
Nothing hold. Was Katherine waiting for him.
Well, exactly, six holding and a half the inch shot. Gap. Yes, a few more exacting shots are having to be played now by Katherine Rednall, and she's starting to feel on them a little bit. And that's all been generated from the first two balls, Laura Daniels.
Yeah, Laura started to ask questions of Katherine.
Trying very hard with
very
this.
Good effort. Can she make it?
Oh, that was a great effort.
One green.
The right idea, coming in on that side just to hide the ball.
Yep. Katherine's looks in an awkward position on the other side, the short ball.
Everything's in a line as well.
Yeah, she's playing the same. Got to stay quite close to those front balls. She hasn't got the pace.
Nope, didn't push through it. But again, those hard shots are difficult. She knows
one
that.
One shot, Laura Daniels.
If you're a little bit heavy, you won't get back to centre rink, so everything has to be perfect.
3-5 for 6-end.
Champion trophy, the Langham Glass. I could fill that full of jelly babies.
Oh, I thought you were going to say gin.
I'm covered there. My nephew owns a gin company.
Jack length, 28 and a half metres.
Needs to slide in front of the red one. Well, oh, I think she just maybe dropped away. Well, this shot gives you an idea of just how wide the balls have to travel. And it's quite narrow this year. Usually it can be a foot or two outside that normally. And then the bias comes all the way back to bring it into centre rink. Takes effect about two-thirds of the way down. But if you know how to use the mat, you can hold that to three-quarters. And you get a deep bend at the end. It's good. Good ball there.
One.
Just in case one Katherine green. Gets a bit excited and decides to go for this. It's only the one in it. There have been two. I had a feeling she might have been interested. But with one shot, just keep drawing. Another chance now. He's got the back position, so try and drop another one in to score a double.
Timeout call. Laura has three timeouts remaining.
Totally different match in the second set. Got a chance, needs to run off her own. Oh, she's been a bit unlucky again.
She hasn't, she's changed the angles there.
It's still just the one.
Still just one.
Oh, but that's twice she's hit the red ball.
She didn't hit it in the right. It could have gone better, couldn't it?
Katherine's looking at the score, thinking to herself, well, if I hit into this, what's going to happen?
Trouble is, that head is really tempting to hit.
Katherine has two timeouts remaining.
It's calling out to her.
It is. It's saying, hit me. But if she's just half a ball off target, she could get her own ball.
Yeah, that's the danger. Taking her own ball clean out for three down. And it wouldn't be too difficult to do that.
I wouldn't worry about it. 6-3 with four ends to go. That's okay.
I think she might play it.
Interesting. Well, she's coming through on the inside. That's safe enough. I couldn't see her getting the shot on that side, but still just the one. No damage done.
Thanks. One shot, Laura Daniels.
Here she comes, under the head, onto the front green ball. So one down, not too much bother at this stage.
Certainly nothing to worry about. The 11 ends makes a big, big difference. Well, Katherine has got four ends to bring back three shots. Laura has to keep pushing through and get the gap as wide as possible.
Track length 27 metres.
Shorter, 2.5 feet short of Jack High.
It's going to need all the weight to get it here in time. It's not bad. Dropped inside. better line with this one.
She's trying here. Great ball.
One red.
Just pulling it around the corner and hiding it as well. Perfect.
Yes, got the middle of the jack, but dropped down in front. Short balls are now very tricky, hard to negotiate. Not far away for weight. Just needs to run. The line was perfect. Again, just needed a foot of weight. Now on the first set.
One shot, Katherine Rednall.
Katherine Rednall was adding those last balls and scoring with them. Not the same this time.
Track length, 24 metres.
It's not bad when it's a foot or so away, but I think that's very beatable.
I think the second set's had a very different feel to it. First set, Katherine was nailing it with the first ball, and if she wasn't, she was correcting with the second. And this set, she just dropped off a tiny bit. And Laura's upped her game as well at the same time. Certainly not wide with this one. Needs to run the distance though. Just sneaked in. I think that's
one
a
red.
Shot back. It is. Shot. Oh, Laura, you have to give this a chance. Need to be reaching.
No. Got
little
the catch.
Touch.
One green.
can Laura add this time?
Well, there's a little bit of danger, though, any touching the jack, and if she holds on to it, it'll be a single, but certainly won't be a double. Coming up to have another look to see maybe on the backhand if there's anything available. You know, bowl out for three.
On out call.
But it's hard to get, just
Laura
hard to get it absolutely full.
It's hard, but there's no danger on the backhand because anything onto Katherine Rednall's front short bowls or onto Laura's as well. So the danger is less on the backhand.
And what she's looking at, if she can get that, it'll bring in. Well, that's shot already, but that's a number two. She could stay for three. She gets it absolutely plumb. Alternatively, just draw on the high side into there if she can. It's one of those shots that looks pretty safe, but she got the outside edge of the red. It would be very unlucky.
Just going to give it a go.
Now, this is the struggle to get back to the bowl. And if you're not going to hit it properly, miss it completely. Good effort.
It was worth it.
One shot, Laura Daniels.
Well, we're really at the business end now of the second set.
4-7 after 9-8.
Two to go. Laura Daniels will be thinking to herself, one shot here, going to the last end, four up, two shots, you win the set. Katherine Rednall, well, she needs to score. Give herself any chance in the last end.
Jack length, 28 and a half metres.
It's almost like a different player in the second set, but it's just taking time for Laura Daniels to settle into this match.
Just started to see a few short bowls creeping from Katherine Rednall as well, which we haven't seen previously. Last few ends, she's dropped short a few times, which is unlike her.
Just not going to make the trip, and that's the one that you really want to focus on. Okay, yes, the first ball is very important, but if you get it in, the second one needs to be there.
Yeah, it's consolidating with the second, isn't it?
Yep, keeps the pressure on. Giving Katherine a wide go at this. Yep, door wide open. Can't she take advantage?
She can.
One red.
Excellent ball.
Just a little touch of the front red, sat down. Thank you very much, shot ball.
Not easy to beat.
No.
Backhand.
Not a lot of other options in the draw either.
Backhand, there's an option to turn the ball over, but it's quite narrow. Forehand, well,
this is a bit nothingy.
Yep, that's a lost ball. Now, Lord Daniels needs to go for the set here. Draw another one. Still needs to run. Can't fall away. Oh, it has. If it had held onto the ball, it was good enough for two. As it is, just the one. I wonder, will she take the risk here in the backhand? Forehand's an absolute draw. Backhand, can't see her doing an awful lot of damage, to be honest.
Well, it doesn't matter. She'll play the backhand and she'll try and turn her ball, just slip round it.
Yep.
She needs to score. She's very tight.
Yep, not going to do it with this one. That'll wing away very quickly.
One shot, Laura Daniels.
Set score 4-8 after 10 ends.
Laura Daniels has come back strong in this match. Second set, 14-2. Just looked all at sea, but she's come back with the first two balls. Are starting to really operate. Sees herself now with four shots in front coming into the last end. If Katherine scores a four, she wins the match and the championship. But if not, we'll be into a three-end tiebreak.
Length 29 and a half metres.
It's not bad. Come away from the centre of the rink, and that's no bad thing. Well, I would leave that one there and change onto the other side, or else go very wide. Short ball when you need four shots.
It's not the best start when you're looking for a four.
Well, if you're playing green, you don't want to hit it in either. Difficult to get four shots now with two short balls. So Daniels just push this one out a little bit further. Pack the head into the tiebreak.
Yeah, I think a bigger problem is that Katherine seems to have lost her pace.
Yes, definitely lost the weight. Well, that should be the end of it.
Football coming in there.
Yeah, probably a backhand runner and hope that something stays. Yeah, there she goes, just trying to keep it in the head if she can. If this goes into a ditch, it's all over. Yep, there we go.
Three shots in the second set. Laura Daniels, match tiebreak.
Massive comeback by Laura Daniels from Wales there. An excellent effort by Katherine to try and take a couple of balls out. Found the gap, goes in a ditch. That makes it dead. Three shots to green.
Laura won the toss and is elected to take the jack on the first end.
That's interesting.
She did the exact same last night in the tie break.
Yep. Toss of the coin, she won the set. Quite often you give the jack away, so you have the last ball. But because of the length of jack that these players have been playing, there's been quite a discrepancy. Laura Daniels wants to keep hold of the jack. She sees that as an advantage. And she's probably going to go longish with this.
Jack length, 28 and a half metres.
Well, just a metre short of full length. Laura Daniels fought her way back in this match. 14-2 down on the first set. Didn't play the last two ends. Different story in the second set. Pushed it all the way through and won it. 11 shots to 4. And now we're into a tie break. And this championship's really up for grabs. Katherine Rednall, so good in the first set. Just come off her game a little bit in the second, and that was enough for Laura to get back in again. But this is a tie break. This is different. Three ends, just win the end. Doesn't matter how many shots to score, and that's different from other competitions. Some competitions have accumulated scores over the tied ends. The tiebreak ends, so this one, all you have to do is win it. A good start and a good backup ball as well with the second delivery.
Very good two opening balls. Taking the jack, taking command, two really good balls. Very close here. Can she hold on for that jack?
Oh, unlucky. Yeah, puff there, the cheeks. Very unlucky. All right, Laura, don't go anywhere near this. Play the backhand. Stay away from it.
Making contact, just not catching it full enough.
Doesn't want to frame this.
Needs to get down quickly.
It's not pretty bad,
good.
Actually.
It's a good ball. Very good ball.
A little bit more in front of the jack would have been a real bonus. Katherine going heavy. And going narrow. Her own ball's gone. Doesn't really matter about the closest one there because she was two down anyway. She needs to score the shot. We'd be running for position now. Look at the respots. As Catherine's got one of those. The problem is she can't cover both respots, so has to go for the one where the red is definite.
Yeah, the jack is more likely to squeeze over to the left from this position. Actually, Katherine hitting it on her forehand.
There it is on the right side of your screen. The red ball with the white dot beside it. I don't think she's wide enough for this. Katherine could actually win this end. That was a missed ball. Could cost her. Catherine's interested.
She's wider this time. She's very close to the front green.
Oh, wow.
First end, Laura Daniels.
Exactly, Catherine. You were so close with that. Laura Daniels had played the perfect end into the last ball. That comes out with it. It's a single. That's good enough. Doesn't matter how many balls are scoring, they just put a single down. Runway lights in the ceiling over the portable rink, and they're very bright.
Track length 28.5 metres.
Laura and our favourite long jack length starts off again with a good ball. Looking good again. Needs to pick up the jack and hide it.
Really good ball.
Oh, doesn't want to frame it, and that's what's happened. It's not bad, don't get me wrong, it's a good ball. But Katherine Rednall is a very good weight shot player. Going for it.
It's very interesting how the dynamics completely changed in this game. Midway through the second set, Laura's just taking it up a gear, like she had to. And Katherine just being put under pressure and now finds herself in a bit of trouble.
Well, two balls could disappear. If Jack goes on the re-spot, there's going to be plenty of room. So Laura really needs another ball in, preferably just behind the green balls, but beating the red one.
Deep.
Well, that's one re-spot covered.
Yeah.
Just see it in the right-hand side of your picture. A little white dot. Katherine will go again. She has to get the two balls out. Might miss a one. Unusual for her to miss with two.
She's closer this time. Needs to hold though.
My goodness me. Look at the puff of the cheek. She thought that was close.
Yes.
We thought it was close.
It looks a lot closer. It's that last yard.
What do you do now? Well, Laura, you've one side covered.
Thing is, Katherine hitting it with that pace, if any jack contact, it's likely it's going in the ditch or it's going out. So
yeah,
I'll try and cover the other side.
There's the re-spot, and the danger ball really
Laura has one timeout
is this one. That's a real danger ball. So it is possible to put a third ball in and cover the re-spot, but it's very precise.
I think my priority would be the other re-spot.
And hope that the two balls don't disappear.
Yeah, keep my fingers crossed. Maybe toes as well.
I think you might have to, Miss Katherine, because she's such a good hitter. Now, will this stay in the right position? Oh my, she lost both. Oh, she's got the re-spot, I think. Just. But if the two balls disappear, it will be into the third end of the tie-break. It's all on Katherine Rednall now to save this match with her last ball. Backhand drive. This looks like the best of the three.
Yeah, she's very close. Front ball.
Jack's gone. It'll go onto the re-spot, and the cover that was put in earlier
Is
the one that's going to count. And Katherine, very magnanimous
Laura Daniels.
Right away. Well done. Big comeback from Laura Daniels. First set didn't reflect her play in any way. She was much better than that. Losing at 14-2, but she really commended her own in the second set. As the two players discuss the game, as they often do when it comes to sport. It was a very, very good win by Laura Daniels, because Katherine Rednall, she really took off, and it was like a steam train that first set. But we'll get confirmation of the score. There we go, 14-2, 4-11 for Laura Daniels in the second set. Wins the tiebreak by 2-0, but played a wonderful tiebreak. Really good, clever bowls, and thoroughly deserved the win. We'll see from the stats, it'll be pretty close. Yep, there we go, ends one. Shot, total shot scored, well, 14-2 was at the first set, and the touchers very close. Average jack length just a little bit longer with Laura Daniels, and she proved that by taking the jack during the tiebreak ends. Well, we expected a good game with these two players, previous winners, of course. And the first set, well, Katherine Rednall was just unbelievable, exceptional. Lifted a big four, and that was on the fourth end. Just continued after that by scoring two doubles, a single, a double, and another single. That's one of them to lift the set, 14-2. The second set, we saw Laura Daniels coming into it. First set, she couldn't buy a shot, but the second set was different. It's almost like somebody came along and flicked a switch, and the true Laura Daniels came out. Perfect draw shots, end after end, building heads. Katherine under pressure. And the first two balls, well, they started to really get going. And in the end, Katherine just couldn't get herself out of enough trouble with the weight shots. But very good tiebreak ends by Laura Daniels, and that got her over the line. And she is the match play champion.
It was a terrific final and a tremendous comeback from Laura Daniels. Katherine, first of all, we have to ask you about how you have coped with the day, because I imagine the emotions must have been all over the place today.
Yeah, it's been a funny one, really, going from the game against Alex and then obviously straight into this one. Got off to a flyer in the first set and sort of carried on how I had been, and then Laura came right back at me in the second set. I scratched around sort of first few ends in that, but Laura was all over it, and then in the tie break she did exactly what you want to do and nailed it, so can't do much else.
I know nobody will want to make excuses at all, but was there any tiredness and fatigue? You've been on here since since 12:45 this afternoon.
I feel shattered, put it that way. Yeah, just probably concentration more than anything. It is so intense, and to concentrate for that amount of time is a big ask, and probably should have reset myself in the second set a little bit more, but got off to a good one in the first set. So, you know, you can't do anything about Laura starting to find a way.
Indeed, and that's to take nothing away, Laura, from a fabulous performance. Because after that first set, it's possible for a lot of players to be a little bit demoralised. So I guess you've shown the character of a champion today.
Yeah, I think that's the thing with set play. You've almost got the opportunity to reset yourself in that second set. You almost feel like you're starting afresh. I knew I had to do something. I said to Katherine when we finished, my actually preferred length up until now has been a shorter jack. Yeah. But that was the one that Katherine was just peppering the jack in that first set. So I thought, well, I've got a length in it. I've got nothing to lose. I've just got to keep plugging away, really. It ain't over till it's over. So.
No, and the way that you played in the tiebreak, as Katherine said, nailed it, was her own quote.
Well, I've had a lot of practice at tiebreaks now. I just knew I had to get my first bowl in there. Obviously, the later you leave it as you're going through your four bowls, the harder it gets. So I just felt if I could get my first bowl in there and put Katherine under pressure, like she did to me in the first set. And then it's just building. It's been probably my second bowl has been my weak bowl. It's just following up on my first. But with a tiebreak, you've got to get that first ball.
It's been a while since you've had your hands on this trophy.
Yeah.
I want to keep you waiting on getting on it much longer. Just tell us what, before you do, what it means to you to be the champion once again.
Oh, it's great. It's been a rematch between me and Katherine. I won it back in 2015. So it's been a long time. But as I said, every trophy is special, whether you've won it before, whether it's your first time. It's been a massive credit to Katherine. She's braver than I am. I stopped playing when I was four or five months. So she's been outstanding all the way through. So credit where credit's due. It was a good match. I had to dig in deep.
Yeah. She's not done yet.
She's got plenty more to come, I'm sure.
You, in the meantime, you can celebrate. So I'll ask you to put the mic down and then use both hands to put them on this trophy that you won in 2015. You can do it once again. The 2021 Just Ladies World Match Play Champion, Laura Daniels.
Yeah, I think that it was me that had a shot go viral, which was, nice and unusual, I guess.
That would be Nikki Brett.
That was my pairs partner, Nikki Brett.
That's one of my good friends, that's Nikki Brett.
Nikki Brett. And it started off with 10 million hits. It then moved on to 20 million hits and eventually topped out at over 50 million hits.
That's all we've got time for now, so don't forget to join us live for the next session. Until then, please stay safe and stay home.